Hi guys, morning. So first of all, thank you so much for tuning into my channel. It's very cold here. I'm in Tirthan Valley right now. So the main reason for this particular video is to review on the 16-day journey, amazing journey I would say, what I had starting from Chennai, and I've completed till Shimla. So
yes,
on October 19th we have started from Chennai to Delhi. Second half of the day we decided that we'll go to two other monuments inside Delhi itself. That's Lotus Temple and Qutub Minar. We got this metro, we reached directly at the Qutub Minar station and then we went to Qutub Minar. There's an option where you, if you want, you can stand in the queue or maybe you can do an online transaction and get into the Qutub Minar as soon as possible. So we did the online transaction. It was around 245 rupees for two people, and we went in, we took some good pictures there, you know. So Lotus Temple, we didn't have much time because we went during the evening hours, 4:30 to 5. So we went, we just had a quick glance of the Lotus Temple, we took some captures and then we came back. We had an already pre-planned itinerary to go to Agra. So we got the help of Southern Travels. They are one of the best travels in Delhi, and their cab came to pick us up by around 5:30 near Pitampura metro station. Once we reached Agra, we went to Taj Mahal first, and we had a guide already been pre-booked. So he had taken all the responsibility of getting the tickets, everything to enter Taj Mahal and Agra. Agra. Once we reached Taj Mahal, it took around like 1 hour approximately for getting your tickets because it was crowded heavily. And oh hi. So this is Gulab. We have another companion as well. And once we completed Taj Mahal, we went to Agra Fort. Even in Agra Fort, we got to learn a lot of interesting information, you know, about our rulers. So Agra Fort is actually, I would say, it's a shared fort between four people inside the same family. So Akbar had the Agra Fort, and then Shah Jahan was actually home present there by his son. After a great experience in Agra Fort, we went to a Krishna temple I think the name of the Krishna temple is Mathura. It's a very famous Krishna temple. So we had a good darshan there as well. And then we returned back to Delhi. So we reached Delhi by around like 11:30 in the night. So Southern Travels was very good enough to understand that I have a lady with me. So they provided a cab until the doorstep, and we were dropped, and yes, the day was ended in a very good manner. The next day was completely about resting, so we had a good rest at home, and by night we had reached to Delhi station because we had to board the Nizamuddin train which was going towards Amritsar. So we reached the station early, and then we boarded the train. We had a good sleep in the train, and then we reached Amritsar by morning by 6:30. Once we reached there, we had already pre-booked a chartered car from there. The travel's name is Aurora. They have been a very close friend of my dad, and so our cab driver Jashpal, he had reached out to Amritsar station. He had a warm welcomed us, and then we got into the car. We actually booked a Toyota Etios sedan version, and we actually reached our hotel, the whole hotel Holy Shrine. There was a little bit of confusion on the booking because we did the booking via Make My Trip, but it had actually given the code of OYO, and as per update from that particular holy city, they said that they don't consider OYO's booking. So there was a little bit of confusion, then we had to make a last minute cancellation and then pay it in cash. But yeah, I would not say that's a hurdle, but the hotel manager was good enough that he said that we'll deal with this by evening, end of the day. Why don't you go to the room and have a good rest? We left to Golden Temple. We had a good time in Golden Temple. We had a good darshan as well there. It's like, you know, a great moment for the eye to see the Golden Temple, you know, and have a good darshan there. After Golden Temple, we had gone to Jalianwallahbagh. I would say nothing majorly to see there. The only thing is, you will know the large massacre which happened during the British. And you have two kind of, like the well which has been already covered right now, and the place where the Britishers fired from. Those are the two points which are there in Jalianwallahbagh. But yes, for the people who has learned this in history during their education, can have an opportunity to come and see here and just see it once. That's it. So yes, we finished Jalianwallahbagh, and then we did some quick shopping there in Amritsar. We were back to the hotel, and by 2:30 our cab driver came in, and we were off to Vagha border. It was a great moment there, because we had the marching parade, as well as, you know, we had a kind of a ceremony there, because we, on the other side we had Pakistan border, and on the this side we had our Indian border. We had the Indian force, like border security force, BSF, you know, do the complete activities there. We had some great songs played, like Vande Mataram, and it was a great moment. And we spent around 2 hours there in Nagar, and then we got back. Once the parade everything was completed, we came out immediately, and we took our cab and got back to our hotel. The next day we actually started from Amritsar directly to Dalhousie. So it was a 4.5 hour journey, and we came via Palanpur. So on the way to Palanpur, we had a break, and we had stopped there. We had seen a couple of military vehicles going past that area, and because that's kind of a very fragile area, we had to be moving very quickly. So we had a quick break, and then we left forward. We checked into the hotel by around 3:30 in the afternoon, and then we had a good lunch there. The manager was already prior informed that we'd be reaching there by this time, so we had kept all the lunch everything ready. We went, we had our lunch, beautiful scenery from the balcony from Dalhousie. We had some great views there. And once after that, we didn't go out much, because that's the first day, and we were really tired because it was extremely cold there. So we had slept for the day, and we have actually started the next day morning from Dalhousie to the next spot. So we have started from Dalhousie the next day at around 8 o'clock. And we proceeded towards Khajjiar, but it's a great place during the winter, because Khajjiar is like a landscape. Generally they call it as, you know, the mini Switzerland of India. So the place is beautiful only, I have no doubts on it, but during summer it doesn't look that great, because obviously it's completely pine trees everywhere, and it's a huge marshland, and you have a small lake in between which is also a little bit dirty. And during winter, if you go there, it's one best place to actually hang around, because all the pine trees will be covered with snow, the whole scenery will be with snow, the lake will be snow, the whole meadows also will be snow. It'll be a great time actually during winter. But anyways, it was a great experience. We saw the mini Switzerland of India. We had a good time there. On the way, we had our breakfast. We had a nice local bhel puri. Then we went to the Shiva temple, we took some good photography there. What we did was, after finishing the Shiva temple, we went directly to the, not to Dharamshala, we went directly to our hotel. We stayed in a hotel called as Himalayan, a very well maintained hotel, you know, it was good. We had a good experience there. We didn't go out much because we were really tired that day, so we had a good sleep. And hold on, my girly friend is here. My girlfriend is here. Look there, over there. This is my puppy doggy. So her name is actually Gulab, and her partner Jamun is that's it. So we call them Gulab Jamun. So it is done. See there? So Gulab. And the next day morning from Meklagunj, we had gone to a couple of other places, like the cricket stadium, which is a famous cricket stadium. It was beautiful. I'll be sharing the complete photos as well as the videos. And then we went to Chintpurni temple, we went to Jwalamukhi temple, we went to Kangra fort. It is one of the best fort. After Agra fort, the one which I liked was Kangra fort, because it was not actually constructed. It was in a similar way how it was, like too much of damage during British ruling time. So it was great experience there. Went to Kangra temple as well. Then we ended the day at Palampur. So Palampur, we had a good sleep. We had a dinner and lunch there, and then we had a good sleep. Then the next day morning from Palampur, we visited a few more places called Baijnath Temple. We went to Beer Monastery. We went to Chocolate Monastery. We went to the Beer Tea Factory. But the tea factory was closed for public due to security reasons. So we had to cancel that. And we had actually stayed in Palampur in a hotel called Hotel UHL. It's Himalayan, Himachal Pradesh government's like small quarters which they provide for the guests. So we had a good sleep there. After Palampur, the next day we were planning to go to Manali. So Manali, what we did was, while on the way itself from Palampur, we went to Bath Valley. Bath Valley was excellent. It was beautiful scenic view. We took some great videos. Then we had a dip inside the ice cold Bias water. We actually got an opportunity to do white water rafting in Bias. It was a great experience. Me and Soumya enjoyed it a lot, and we had a great time. After this, what we did was, we went back home, we had a good sleep. Then from the next day, what we did was, we went to Cholang Valley, and also we went to Rotang Pass. Rotang Pass experience was completely in a different level. We started early in the morning by 5:30. We reached the Rotang Pass by 7 o'clock. And we were the first one to do skating, ice skating, snow skating, I would say. And then we had some great time there in Rotang. Once after Rotang was completed, we came back home. We had a good rest, had lunch, had dinner. We had good rest there. Then the next day was towards Kulu. So what we decided was, being in Himachal Pradesh, being in the Himalayas, you know, we should travel by bike. That's the best experience for any biker. And me being a hardcore biker, I really wanted to take a bike and go rather than taking the car and going. So we did give a break for the driver. We told him to stay back in Manali. We hired a Himalayan, Royal Enfield Himalayan, and we proceeded towards the other places like Nagar Castle, then Roich Art Gallery, Hadimba Temple, and then Jana Waterfall. After we finished Jana Waterfall, we came back to the base where we hired the bike. We were there for by around 5:36 we were down, and then we had a good chai there, and we called up our cab driver, and he came out to pick us up. After Kulu, the next day we had actually travelled to Tirthan Valley. Initially we thought that it's just a place for doing the river crossing in the small box, but after coming here I did feel that Tirthan Valley is one of the best thing I have seen in this trip, because it's peace, it's calm, and it's a paradise. It's a paradise for everyone who travels here. We have actually stayed in a hotel, in a homestay called as Forest Edge, and people here are very nice. The manager is excellent. He was he kept on updating us on status, how we feel, are we comfortable, what kind of food do we like, all the details were inquired. So our itinerary for today is, we'll be starting back to Shimla. We'll be going to Shimla. We'll be staying in Shimla for a day, and then we will be proceeding further to Delhi from Shimla. So we'll stay for a day in Delhi, and the next day we are back to our old pavilion, that's Chennai, where our IT work again starts. So this is a short brief on the complete touring what I've done right now, but it's been a great and amazing experience, and I feel Soumya also would have felt the same, that it's a great journey. So much for all your love and affection and your support you have given today. So thank you so much, and you all have a great rest of the day. Take care, bye. Started moving too fast.